A lot of people use an LLC to shield them from the liability of a rental or investment property. But unless your LLC is well established, and even sometimes when it is, the financial responsibility of the legal entity can fall on the shoulders of its members. This is especially true for lending. Whenever you're borrowing money for a real estate investment, it's important to understand the difference between recourse and non-recourse loans. Nearly every type of funding for residential and small commercial investments will include a personal guarantee. This guarantee is attached to the borrower or borrowers as an added fail-safe for the lender. In the event of a default, the lender will first use the collateral pledge against the loan. Most of the time, this happens through a foreclosure auction or through a foreclosure and an REO sale on the MLS. The bank or lending institution uses a legal process to take control of an asset or to take ownership. They'll then sell off the property to recoup their investment, lost interest, attorney fees, and other fees. After the asset's sold, there may still be an outstanding balance or debt obligation. Whether the property is owned by an entity or an individual, many times the lender will pursue a payment agreement or judgment from the individuals that guarantee the loan. These type of loans are called recourse or recourse loans. A non-recourse loan limits the lender to foreclosure and sale proceedings upon default. So with few exceptions, these types of loans are made against large commercial properties with an underlying or an innate value. They tend to start at about $2 million and go up from there. Now, the value is usually based on long-term leases or a sustained history of occupancy. Additionally, these types of loans usually require a larger down payment. They're amortized over a shorter time frame, like 10 to 25 years, and the interest rate resets throughout the loan term. With non-recourse loans, there's a lower risk to the lender. As long as the assets are properly managed, their value, it doesn't fluctuate as significantly as smaller assets. Within the past few years, however, many non-recourse lenders have been adding some surprises to their loan agreements. These surprises include something called a default judgment. Now, default judgment's a document that allows lenders to enter a guilty plea on behalf of the borrower in the event of a loan default. So essentially, the lender goes to court on behalf of the borrower and enters a guilty plea. So they're not used everywhere, and they're not even valid in all 50 states. But in Pennsylvania and several others, default judgments seem to be a loophole to this non-recourse loan. If you're considering borrowing money to fund your next investment project, make sure you understand the terms of the loan. Because that you're buying a house in the name of your LLC doesn't mean you're not liable for that money if things go south. The goal of every investor should be profit. A good lender can help get you there. Ultimately, it's an investor's responsibility to choose the right funding source and to execute on their plan.